Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have leveled up Henry quite a bit. We got Warfare up to level 12. Yeah, we're gonna put that. We got Sword level 13, which isn't bad. I could have gotten more. But, you know, if I just max him out really early, there's, you know, it's going to be kind of boring down the game, you know, in the long run. As long as you remain still, your tiredness and hunger. Okay, that's not bad. Golden tongue. First aid. Brute. Yeah, I think I want to get brute. Oh, we got strength below 15. Sword and unarmed 13 and 10. So yeah, Henry's pretty decked out right now. So let's just you know, go to sleep really quick. All right. Let's just go to sleep. And we get waked up in the middle of the night. Lost items.
Yes?
It is I, Henry. Forgive the intrusion. I didn't wake you, boy, did I?
My lady, no, no, not at all. But what brings you here at this hour?
I thought you could do with a little wine.
Well, that's nice of her.
Just what you need. You sleep.
My lady, thank you. You really shouldn't. You could have sent a servant.
I was going.
A servant?
But to tell you the truth, I couldn't sleep either. I thought of you while saying my prayers. How awful it must have been for you. I came to offer you solace, to let you know you're not alone.
Thank you. Thank you kindly.
You're welcome. Now, Henry, I know this is all very new and strange for you, but I want you to feel at home here. You're not to worry about anything except getting better.
Well, that's nice of her.
I suppose you've been through a terrible ordeal. I know what it is to be left alone in the world. Although your loss is much greater. But with God's help, the pain will ease in time. And it can help to talk about it, if you feel like it.
Oh. Well, it looks like there's a glitch and I'm not actually in the cutscene. What the hell? Let's tell her about it. It'll improve her speech skill.
I'll tell you what happened. It was terrible and unexpected. The day started just like any other. Father sent me into town on some errands.
Let's just say this.
I went to the tavern to buy I know it's a job for a groom, but I didn't mind, because my girl Bianca worked there. I courted her a while, and we agreed to meet in the evening, but our meeting was never to happen.
No.
Dear boy.
When I'd done all the errands, I headed back home. I promised
father he's there.
His work, and I was looking forward to it. He was forging a sword for Sir Radzin.
So what, sword fighting?
Sword fighting and hiding it from my parents. So when we assembled the sword, I tried a few moves with it. There's a big difference between a wooden sword and a real one. Maybe if I hadn't taken that sword in my hand, I wouldn't be here today.
You're full of surprises.
But Sigismund's horde was already on the horizon, ready to attack the town.
It actually worked. Let's talk about the army.
Sigismund's cavalry was composed of humans. They're diabolical barbarians from the east, with no regard for the rules of warfare. Bloodthirsty cutthroats. The very fact Sigismund has them with him shows what a tyrant he is.
True.
Yes.
And then death descended on Skalitz.
Let's talk more about the attack.
I've seen a raid before, and it was terrifying. Moaning of the wounded, death rattles, the terrible screams as swords passed through flesh. It was nothing but confusion, blood, and death.
Try not to think of it.
To the castle, like our neighbors, to take cover, but I didn't make it. I had to find another way to save myself.
Yeah, I could have made it. We closed the door on me. With a bridge.
I was lucky I knew a concealed path around the castle.
Nice. Let's just say you ran for your life.
I ran as if my life depended on it, which it did. But my guardian angel watched over me, and I made it to the mill below the castle.
It's as well you did. The Lord be praised.
Then I heard a scream. It was Teresa, the mill wench. She'd been caught by a gang of Cuman savages who planned to violate her. She had Sir Radzik's sword, and even though there were several of them and they were better armed, I had to try and save her. I wanted there to be at least one person I'd helped. And I succeeded, even though it almost cost me my life. After that, I stole a horse from them and rode off.
Like a valiant knight.
I'll never forget the horror. It will haunt me for the rest of my life.
Oh, damn.
That's terrible. How could something like that happen?
God alone knows why he lets such things happen.
Oh, you poor
boy. Dang.
I understand your grief, but God is not to blame for the ills of this world. That is the work of Satan and those who do his bidding. Those who are corrupted by greed, envy, and pride. You must not lose faith, whatever life brings.
Oh yeah, she has a point.
Been merciful to me and my husband either. Although in comparison to the horrors you went through. I was young when I married my husband. It was my father's wish. Divish was a lot older than I, but a woman must bear her lot. Shortly after our marriage, before I even got a look at Talmberg, the castle was stormed and my husband was imprisoned.
Really?
My husband had some quarrel with Sir Havel Medek of Valdek, who decided to resolve it by force. He stormed the castle, burned down the village of Pribislavitz, and killed many of our men, even the old chamberlain. He imprisoned my husband in the castle and put his own garrison there.
Damn. I killed the new chamberlain. I remember.
I was barely 18 years old, and all of a sudden, I was left alone with Sir Robert. We didn't know what to do. We went to Prague to appeal to the king and sought help from Divish's friends, but all to no avail. We tried for years, but it seemed I was destined to be left alone and my husband to rot in jail in his own castle.
Years, you say?
It's a long time.
That's how long it
7 years.
Condemned as an enemy of the crown.
That's a really long time.
And then he refused to surrender the castle and release my husband. In the end, I raised the money to pay a ransom And only then, by the grace of Lord Jesus, did I finally lay eyes on my husband once more.
7 years. And was Harville punished for it?
Never. And after 7 years, my husband returned to me an infirm old man.
Dang.
Sir Divish seems like a good, strong man.
Well, certainly, only he has many concerns. He had to rebuild Talmberg. After he was released, the king appointed him Burgrave of Prague Castle, and he was very busy. He had no time for me at all. But at least we were in the city, and there was something going on. And now, we're here.
My lady, you're still young and beautiful. Your best years are still ahead of you.
Would that that were true, lad. Would it were true. What am I doing bothering you with this? You have troubles enough.
She's saying it's not true.
I'll go and let you sleep.
All right, just take the food.
I enjoyed our little talk, Henry. Good night, and God bless.
Good night, my lady.
Good night, woman. Well, my lady. Or Lady Stephanie, I forgot what her name was. I believe that's what it was. Well, Henry will go to sleep now in his heavy armor. Even though Sir Rode Bard told him to take off his dirty shoes. Ah, fuck, what's this? Oh, he's having a nightmare. And he called him a fucking coward.
Henry, wake up. You don't want to miss this.
What's happening?
Come to the battlements. One of our patrols reported a company heading here from Skellets.
Well, looks like you gotta go check it out. I still wanted though. If I'm still wanted, then why the fuck were they? Oh, that's not good.
Surrender! You've committed a violation. You're under arrest.
Come here, you bitch. This guy is making very hard right now. There we go, there we go. We did it. Do you have any other goodies on you? Specifically something to help my health. Moonshine, well, it's something, I guess. Even though it's probably just gonna get me drunk. It is what it is.
The best thing would be
surrender! You'll have to answer for your law breaking.
What's the matter? Come on.
Oh yeah, I did it. Give me all your goodies, man. Give me this thing too. Alright, I believe that fight is over. Who wants more? I know these fuckers are up here waiting for me. Didn't have any of the good stuff. This guy probably had some of the good stuff. Did you have any savior schnapps? No, you didn't. Frick. I want to see if I could really make something. Not make something, but you know. Steal something good.
Hey! What do you think you're doing?
Hey!
What are you doing?
Fuck it.
What's going on?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Why would Sigismund advance on Talmberg in the night? Especially since he's lost the element of surprise after the raid on Scouts.
Maybe it's not him.
Then who is it? The Scouts Jivis sent
him. Yeah, maybe it isn't him.
Said he'd set up camp and was getting ready to storm the castle. And Sir Radzig is an experienced soldier. He'd surely hold the castle for quite some time. It doesn't make sense.
What else did the spies say?
Not much of anything. Before they could get close enough, this huge storm started. And you were right. Sigismund has a hell of a lot of soldiers, including all manner of mercenaries.
Damn.
Something like that costs a fortune. Well, anyway, we'll find out when they get here, won't we?
Aye, we will.
Oh, that's gonna suck. Well, it's time to wait and see who it is. Who the hell are those guys?
Sir Radzig, what a relief.
Is his lordship there with you?
Yes, sir, he is right here.
What are you doing up so late, Divish? At your age, you need a good night's sleep.
Well, Radzig, you didn't exactly pick the best time for an outing either. In a big hurry?
It was a bit of a scramble, all right. Believe it or not, this tempest is a godsend for me and my men. As my old granddad used to say, better a sore throat than a slit throat.
I'd say your grandfather was a wise man. Your messenger told us what happened.
Messenger?
The lad you sent to warn us.
He's alive? He made it to you?
He's here with me. He only got away by the skin of his teeth, though.
Thank God.
A brave young man. But tell me, friend, how on earth did you manage to get away?
Thank God for this tempest. When it
began, the rain.
Sigismund's Tatars crawled into their holes and left a storm in the castle for more clement weather. We were able to sneak out right under their noses.
Damn. They ninja'd it.
Stood a chance against them.
Would you like to spend the night in Talmberg?
No, no. When Sigismund finds the castle empty tomorrow, he might come looking for us. We'd only be exposing you to danger. Without me and my men, he has no call to attack you.
What will you do then?
We'll march to Ratai. It's only a short way, and there we'll have a better chance of defense and enough room for all of these people. If Sigismund should come, better bend your knee, Divish. There's no point dying in a battle that's futile.
You're right there.
Damn.
Is that boy still with you?
I'm here, sir.
You have courage, lad. That I can't deny. I am sorry about what happened.
I'm being acknowledged.
Would you care to join us?
I'd like to, sir, but first I have to return to Scalitz.
Are you mad? What do you want there?
I can't leave my mother and father. I won't leave their corpses rotting in the street. I'll join you once I've taken care of them.
Don't even think of going back there, you donkey. Are you tired of living?
But sir!
Quiet! I'm sorry about your father, but getting killed as well won't help him. Divish, make sure that lad doesn't budge from Talmberg until things quieten down.
Not to worry, friend.
All right.
He's injured and needs to recover. I'll lock him up here as if he were Havel of Baldic.
I've seen you have thick skin since your tribulation, sir. But thank you.
Havel of Baldic is the guy that kept him in prison for 7 years.
Farewell.
In his own castle, too. That's fucked up.
And good fortune. Give my regards to Sir Hanish.
I will. And good luck to you and your people, too. These are dark times.
Yes, they are, actually. Well, it's like they won't let us back over there. Ah, oh, shit. Hey. I haven't done anything. Oh, I got hit.
And now, you pay for all your crimes. What? Don't bother. It's jail.
Listen, man, I haven't done anything.
You pull in my pizzle. Aye, right.
Fine.
Jail? Get moving.
Fine, let's go. Let's go to jail, let's get it over with.
See if you have anything else suspicious on you.
Everything on me is stolen anyway. I don't care.